Hi guys, this is Ola. It's been a long 7 months of modeling combined with college work. And good news, the past model section of this project is completed. This project was conceived due to my own satisfaction with the kind of projects I've been working with so far. And really, I needed to challenge myself, hence the radial aircraft engine. It has been a long run getting here, trying to share my time in both college coursework and YouTube, but it has been worth it. So, the 57 custom parts of this engine have been completed, and we head into the assembly. The good thing about this sort of project is that more challenges are waiting the assembly, and it provides the opportunity to learn to solve real problems. Some challenges which I can already imagine, however, we would scale through. Important to include, I've been receiving questions on where I got the dimensions from. So there's a website called GrabCAD. Some of you might already be aware of it and some won't. However, it's a community of CAD users where models are uploaded, tutorials are posted, and the likes. So I was able to extract the model from the site and I'm working with the drawing files. For this reason, you can be relaxed in your heart to know that the dimensions will work when we begin the assembly. Nonetheless, I noticed a mistake about some weeks back, but it isn't a serious thing though, except that I have been modeling using the millimeters units, which considering a real aircraft engine, the model is really small. However, that wouldn't be an issue since all the other parts are to the same scale. I also received concerns from viewers on the subreddits on why this project wasn't done using the skeletal modeling approach in order to eliminate the possibility of misfitting parts when the assembly begins. This is really true, and maybe I will next time. However, if you ever face challenges like this, it will be an opportunity to learn how to solve such problems from the assembly workspace. Alright, so for you good people that have been committedly following through with this project, waiting for when the assembly will begin, you guys can smile now because your time to shine is here. But may the force be with your motherboards and processors. Alright, so our approach will be to create sub-assemblies, then use them to finalize the final assembly. This will be fun. Alright, so thanks to all the guys and girls. You know I wouldn't leave the girls out. Thanks to you guys who have subscribed, and to those that haven't, do not forget to do so. Feel free to check through the playlists on my channel, share the videos you see, leave your comments, hit the like button, and especially hit the notification bell to be notified when I make new updates. Because when this project is over, more projects are starting to come. And in the meantime, guys and girls, keep watching this space.